In this example, we are given that two long parallel wires carry current of equal magnitude but in opposite directions. And these wires are suspended from ceiling by four strings of same length L, we can see here. And we are given that the mass per unit length of the wire is lambda, and we are required to determine the value of theta, that is the angle by which the string are diverging, assuming it to be very small. Now, in solution, if we just draw the cross-sectional view of the situation here, we can see these are the wires through which the two wires are suspended. These are the threads through which two wires are suspended. And in this situation, the length of these strings or threads is L. And one wire carries a current I, say here in outward direction, and other is carrying a current I in inward direction. If we consider the separation between the wires as L, the two will repel each other with the magnetic force Fm. And here we can write repulsive magnetic force on wires per meter, that is per unit length, we can write as this magnetic force is mu naught I square by 2 pi r. Here I have taken the length of wire to be unity because we are given with mass per unit length. So in downward direction it will experience its weight, that will be lambda g, because we are talking about per unit length, so it will be lambda g, and the string will carry out tensions T and T. Say if both of these strings will experience a tension T, so we can write in this direction it will be 2T, here also it will be 2T. If this angle is theta, this will also be theta. That is the angle made by string from the vertical. And here we can write for equilibrium of wires per unit length, or we can simply balance out the forces, like in this situation 2t sin theta will be equals to the magnetic force, which is mu naught I square by 2 pi r. And vertical it will be 2t cos theta, which will be balanced by the weight of the wire per unit length, that is lambda g. So in this situation, if we divide the two equations, this will give us 10 theta is equals to mu naught I square by 2 pi lambda. Here you can see it is mu naught I square by 2 pi lambda rg. Now, in this situation, this R we can simply substitute as twice of L sin theta. So, because this half of R is L sin theta, we can write it 2L sin theta. Or, sin theta we can approximate as theta only, so it can be written as 2L theta. Now, in this situation, if we substitute the value of R as 2L theta and 10 theta, we can also substitute approximately equal to theta. So you can see here, theta I can take on left hand side, so this will become theta square is equals to mu naught I square divided by this 2L will be left over here, so this will be 4 pi lambda GL. Now using this, we are getting the value of theta as under the root mu naught I square by 4 pi lambda GL. That will be the answer to this problem.